Footnote to Youth by Jose Garcia Villa. The sun was salmon and hazy in the west. Dodong thought to himself he would tell his father about Taeyang when he got home, after he had unhitched the carabao from the plow and led it to its shed and fed it. He was hesitant about saying it, but he wanted his father to know. Dodong started homeward, thinking how he would break his news to his father. He was 17. He had pimples on his face. The down on his upper lip already was dark. This meant he was no longer a boy. Thinking himself a man grown, Dodong felt he could do anything. In the cool sundown, he thought wild young dreams of himself and Taeyang. Taeyang, his girl. She had a small brown face and small black eyes and straight glossy hair. How desirable she was to him. She made him dream even during the day. It was dusk when he reached home. His parents and he sat down on the floor around the table to eat. Dodong's mother removed the dishes when they were through and went out to the batalan to wash them. His father remained in the room, sucking a diseased tooth. Dodong said while his mother was out that he was going to marry Taeyang.
I am going to marry Taeyang,
Dodong said. His father looked at him silently. The silence became intense and cruel. Dodong was uncomfortable and then became angry because his father kept looking at him without uttering anything.
I will marry Taeyang,
Dodong repeated. His father kept gazing at him in inflexible silence, and Dodong fidgeted on his seat.
I asked her last night to marry me and she said yes. I want your permission. I want it.
There was impatient clamor in his voice, an exacting protest at this coldness, this indifference. Dodong looked at his father sourly. He cracked his knuckles one by one, and the little sounds it made broke dully in the night stillness.
Must you marry Dodong?
Dodong resented his father's questions. His father himself had married.
You are very young, Dodong.
I'm 17.
This is very young to get married at.
I wanted to marry. Taeyang's a good girl.
Tell your mother,
his father said.
You tell her, Tatay.
Dodong, you tell your inay.
You tell her.
All right, Dodong.
You will let me marry Taeyang?
Son, if that is your wish, of course.
There was a strange, helpless light in his father's eyes. Dodong did not read it. So absorbed was he in himself. Dodong was immensely glad he had asserted himself. Dodong stood in the sweltering noon heat, sweating profusely. His mother had told him not to leave the house, but he had left. He was afraid, afraid also of Taeyang. Taeyang was giving birth in the house. She gave screams that chilled his blood. In a few moments, he would be a father. He was young, he realized now. Suppose he had 10 children. What made him think that? He heard his mother's voice from the house. Come up, Dodong. It is a boy. Blas was not Dodong's only child. Many more children came. For 6 successive years, a new child came along. Dodong did not want any more children, but they came. Taeyang did not complain, but the bearing of children told on her. She cried sometimes, wishing she had not married, even if she loved Dodong. Dodong, whom life had made ugly. One night, he stood in the moonlight. He wanted to ask questions and somebody to answer him. One of them was why life did not fulfill all of youth's dreams. Why it must be so. Why one was forsaken after love. Dodong would not find the answer. When Blas was 18, he came home one night very flustered and happy. It was late at night and Taeyang and the other children were asleep. But Blas said he could not sleep.
Blas, you should go to sleep,
Dodong said.
I am going to marry Tona. She accepted me tonight.
Dodong lay silent.
I love Donna, and I want her.
Dodong rose from his mat and told Blas to follow him. They descended to the yard, where everything was still and quiet. He did not want Blas to marry yet. Blas was very young. The life that would follow marriage would be hard.
Must you marry?
Blas' voice is stilled in resentment.
I will marry Tona.
Dodong kept silent, hurt.
You have objections, Itay?
Blas asked acridly.
Son, none. But truly, God, I don't want Blas to marry yet. Not yet.
But he was helpless. He could not do anything. Youth must triumph now. Love must triumph now. Afterwards, it will be life. As long ago, youth and love did triumph for Dodong. And then life. Dodong looked wistfully at his young son in the moonlight. He felt extremely sad and sorry for him.